In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, we come before God. We want to thank Him for all that He has done for us, and He continues to do for us. Let us first acknowledge our sins, and so be ready to celebrate this Holy Eucharist. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who are prepared for those who love you, good things which no eye can see. Fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises, which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The hand of the Lord came upon me and led me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me in the center of the plain, which was now filled with bones. He made me walk among the bones in every direction so that I saw how many there were on the surface of the plain, how dry they were. He asked me, "Son of man, can these bones come to life?" I answered, "Lord God, you alone know that." Then he said to me, "Prophesy over these bones and say to them, 'Dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, see, I will bring spirit into you that you may come to life. I will put sinews upon you and make flesh grow over you, cover you with skin and put spirit in you, so that you may come to life and know that I am the Lord.' I prophesied as I had been told, and even as I was prophesying, I heard a noise. It was a rattling as the bones came together, bone joining bone. I saw the sinews and the flesh coming upon them, and the skin cover them, but there was no spirit in them. Then the Lord said to me, 'Prophesy to the spirit, prophesy, son of man, and say to the spirit, thus says the Lord God, from the four winds come, O spirit, and breathe into these slain that they may come to life.' I prophesied as he told me, and the spirit came into them. They came alive and stood upright, a vast army. Then he said to me, 'Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They have been saying, our bones are dried up, our hope is lost, and we are cut off. Therefore prophesy and say to them, thus says the Lord God, O my people, I will open your graves and have you rise from them and bring you back to the land of Israel. Then you shall know that I am the Lord, when I open your graves and have you rise from them, O my people. I will put my spirit in you that you may live, and I will settle you upon your land. Thus you shall know that I am the Lord. I have promised, and I will do it, says the Lord." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
Let the redeemed of the Lord say, those who he has redeemed from the hand of the foe and gathered from the lands, from the east and the west, and from the north and the south. Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting. They went astray in the desert wilderness, the way of an inhabited city they did not find. Hungry and thirsty, their life was wasting away within them. Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting. They cried to the Lord in their distress, From their straits he rescued them, and he led them by a direct way to an inhabited city. Give thanks to the Lord, his life is everlasting. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his mercy and his wondrous deeds to the children of men, because he satisfied the longing soul and filled the hungry soul with good things. Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting. Please stand. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Teach me your paths, my God. Guide me in your truth.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a scholar of the law, tested him by asking, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments." Dear friends, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So my dear friends, today being Friday, we are being invited to give thanks to God all the time, every moment of our lives, because God is love, God is good. Today we have the first reading from the prophet Ezekiel, where we hear a prophecy which brings everything into being again, which restores life again. Then we have the gospel from Matthew, which talks about the spirit behind the commandments of the law, the dictates of the law, the laws of God. And that spirit is love. I don't know how life is for you, but there are times in life where you feel like you are losing everything. You feel like nothing is working, nothing is going on well. You feel like you have lost everything. My dear friend, today, let the words of the prophet, the words of the Lord inspire you that when you have God, all is not lost. You can find it again. You can have restoration in your life. You know, the people of Israel have gone into a situation in their life where what they could say is that their lives are like dried bones. They have lost all hope. And in fact, they are being cut off from life. And this is where God comes into their lives and uses the prophet Ezekiel to tell them that, nah, you might have gotten dried bones in your life. You might have lost hope. You might have been cut off from life. There is nothing like joy again. But when you have me, God, the God who always wants to boast that he is God, you know what Jesus, God was saying? He said that they will know that I am the Lord, and I promise, and I have done it. That is the God that you serve, the God that I also serve, the God together we are serving this morning. That is a God who wants to let all people know that he is your Lord. He is the one who has created you. He's the one who gives meaning and purpose to life. He's the one who brings things which are destroyed back to life. He's the one who gives new hope and vision to man's life. Whatever that is happening to you, know that God wants to restore you. And that restoration, it's not because he wants to gain something from you, but
It is because he loves you. God loves us. And that is why he wants to restore us today. He wants to restore our life back onto our feet and know that he is God, he promised, and he has done it. And that is why in the gospel, you have, what is the greatest commandment? It's to love God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your spirit. You know, God needs to be loved. Not because God needs our love, but we need to return the love God is always showing to us. I don't know how you have experienced life, but when you lost everything, when you got up in the morning and you thought, this day is not worth moving on. This day is so dead in itself. And all of a sudden, there comes some kind of joy in you, some kind of hope in you, and you rise from your bed and it starts moving. That was God. He loved you and he still loves you. He doesn't want you to follow him because he is just God, but he wants you to follow him because he is the only person, the only God, the only Lord who loves you more than anything. Let this love inspire us today, that as the week comes to an end, we still know that we have God who loves us. May God bless all of us. Amen. Dear friends, let us now turn to our Heavenly Father with these petitions, knowing that he loves us and he hears our prayers. For our mother church throughout the world, may God plant the seed of his word in the hearts of believers and help them to be doers of the word. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. For our public officials, may they be guided by the Holy Spirit in making decisions to protect all of God's people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer under the sin of grudges or hate, may they experience the freedom and peace of God's love and be given the grace of repentance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those of us gathered here, may we be strengthened and comforted daily in the hope of the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls in purgatory, may they soon be welcomed into eternal salvation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray as we offer this Mass for Jack Ward, John, and Camille Dolly, that God's mercy and love will be upon them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in a very special way also for the family of Hector, the wife, the children, the grandchildren, the in-laws, that God's mercy and love will always bring them together, grant them healing and restoration, and be a blessing upon them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, present your private intentions before God. Lord, we thank you for loving us and for never letting our prayers go unheard. In your mercy and love, please answer us according to your will. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness, we have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Let us pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at
your
hands,
for the praise and glory of your name. Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, a death he willingly accepted, he took bread. And giving thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil graciously. Grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your word. Will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer to one another the Son of Christ peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to be shut up. Come to say the word.
Amen. Our spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Made partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God be with you, we humbly pray. And to thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God,
as you do Satan and all
holy evil spirits, now and at the world,
in the world of souls. Amen. Remember,
O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thy intercession, was left unaided,
inspired by his confidence,
flying to thee,
O Virgin of Virgins, our Mother,
to thee do we come, before thee we stand,
sinful and sorrowful,
O Mother of the Bright
Incarnate,
sanctify
my mother and patient,
but to the grace of the Spirit and after death.
Our Lady of Lourdes,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Lourdes,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless and keep you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Have a lovely day.
Thank you, Father.